20 years ago, Gordon Campbell gave huge tax breaks to the corporations and the wealthy in this province, $3 billion a year. It's time to end those tax breaks, put that money back into the provincial treasury. It's time to abolish income taxes on people earning less than $40,000 a year.
Cut emissions now. Stop the Site C Dam, Coastal GasLink Pipeline, and the Trans Mountain Expansion. Invest in renewable energy for British Columbians across the province and prioritize public transit for all.
We need to provide job security for all workers affected by the COVID-19 layoffs, including 100% recall rights to their previous employment and wage security. We also need to implement a $20 an hour minimum wage and secure the labor rights for all migrant, domestic, and agricultural workers. The government also needs to take immediate action to save the forestry and fishing industries.
We demand full recognition of Indigenous title to all traditional territories, an end to resource extraction projects without full consultation and approval, as well as an end to violations of Bill 41, the Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples Act.
End removals from the agricultural land reserve, encourage food production in urban areas.
It's crucial that we put an end to the privatization of our natural resources. We need to put them instead under public, democratic control. We also need to put an end to all public-private partnerships.
The federal government determined that people need at least $2,000 a month to live. That's why we're calling for doubling social assistance and disability rates.
Defund the police and military and reallocate funds for renewable energy, housing, healthcare, and schools.
Increase education spending by $1,000 per student up to the Canadian average. End funding and tax breaks for private and religious schools. Protect health and safety for students, staff, and teachers during the COVID pandemic. And implement SOGI in all school districts.
We demand the construction of 100,000 units of social and low-income housing, a ban on evictions during the pandemic, including the forgiveness of loan debt, a ban on dem evictions and rent evictions, and the legislation of stricter rent controls.
Establish mixed member proportional representation and set MLA salaries at the average wage of a BC worker.
Accelerate plans for province-wide, universal, affordable, quality childcare. Provide funding for women's centers and programs. Provide safe spaces for people escaping misogyny and domestic violence. End the criminalization of sex work. Trans rights are human rights.
After decades of failure, the war on drugs is still continuing in British Columbia. Thousands of people have died and continue to die from overdoses. It's time to put an end to this war on drugs. It's time to provide a safe, guaranteed, reliable, permanent source of safe drugs. It's time to provide housing and incomes for people who are in need. It's time to really tackle this serious, deadly social and health crisis with real harm reduction policies on a comprehensive level.
The capitalist system is killing the planet. We call for socialism, a world without poverty and without war, where working people democratically own and control the economy.
Hi, my name is Kimball Carew. I'm a candidate in the riding of Vancouver Hastings for the Communist Party of BC.
I'm Walter Parsons, and I'm the candidate for Victoria Swan Lake for the Communist Party of British Columbia.
My name's Ryan Abbott. I'm running in Surrey Wally for the Communist Party of BC.
My name's Tyson Strandlin. I'm running in the riding of Langford-Wandefuca for the Communist Party of British Columbia.
My name's Florian Castle, and I'm running in Oak Bay-Gordon Head for the Communist Party of BC.